Right, Lifeline Australia's leading crisis support and suicide prevention organisation is celebrating its 60th birthday today. It was founded in Sydney in 1963 after Reverend Alan Walker took a call from a distressed man who later took his own life. The organisation has taken over 23 million calls and counting. And I'm joined by Lifeline Australia CEO Colin Seery. Colin, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
60 years of Lifeline. A lot of us can't imagine life without there being a number to call. How would you describe it currently?
Yeah, look, the demand, you know, back, you mentioned that first day with Sir Reverend Alan Walker. I think there were about 100 calls to the phone service on that, you know, 60 years ago today. The phone hasn't stopped over the journey. And look, today, I think on the back of some of the challenges of the Australian community, really going back to the 2019 bushfires, obviously the pandemic, floods, your session earlier with Cassandra on the cost of living, the demand is at a 60-year level. So the equivalent of 100 calls 60 years ago through our phone, text and chat service, we'll have over 4,000 contacts today. So we think our need to be here has never been greater.
So with that changing face of need, do the phone operators need to have constant training to be able to counsel on new things like financial matters?
Absolutely. And I think, you know, the vast majority or a lot of the calls at the moment are geared around those, you know, the cost of living issues. And so there is consistent update. Like, the training for our crisis supporters is very intense at the start. And obviously, as new scenarios come on board, the training is enhanced further. And we have, you know, specific services, 13 Help for disaster recovery. We're really proud of 13 Yarn, our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander service. So we are trying to get very specific in terms of the needs of the help seeker.
Do you have an issue with finding people who can operate the phones?
Look, it's a challenge. Obviously, it's not the same as volunteering, you know, for the kids' canteen or the soccer barbecue. So, as I mentioned, there is very sort of detailed training. We have an amazing group of, you know, 4,000 crisis supporters who are trained or on the phones, the text or chat. But it is challenging, and, you know, obviously the topics that are covered are ranging a whole range of areas. So you do have to be a special type of person. And I think the longevity is often a challenge.
How long do phone calls last on average?
So the average is around about 18 minutes.
Yep.
Look, our role is not is to sit there without judgment and just to listen.
And some people call because they're lonely?
Absolutely, yeah. And we have people that call a lot, and we may be the only person that they talk to the day, the week, the month, the year, and we accept that role. A number of people, we are, you know, their reason for being to contact, and we're up for that, obviously.
Colin, it's an incredible service. 60 years, congratulations. Lifeline has saved so many lives and will continue to do so. So
great.
Thank you for joining
us
at Midday. Now, you can phone Lifeline to speak to a crisis supporter on 13 11 14, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.